heavy rains in California, freezing temperatures in Florida, bad news for produce growers and your wallet. News Channel 8's Mark Tauschek here to explain. Mark?
Rough weather jacking up produce prices is nothing new, but this time it's not just one region of the country suffering from the worst weather has to offer.
Right now I'm just really fortunate to be able to get strawberries that are good quality, but they're expensive.
$2 higher than before Christmas. And when Dick Rissman says strawberries are expensive, he's not just making an annoyed observation like the rest of us.
The on-vine tomatoes have gone up probably $1 a pound over what they were.
For almost 20 years, he's been in charge of buying and pricing produce for Dahl's grocery stores. He's watched wholesale prices for items like broccoli and cauliflower double in the past 2 weeks and wrestled with how much to sell them for.
If we priced it where it should be, you know, we'll price ourselves to where it's too expensive for anyone to buy it. So we absorb a lot of it. We'll move our price up a little bit, but we'll definitely absorb a lot of it.
It was quite a shock today to see $1.68 head of lettuce.
Of course, explaining higher prices is little consolation to shoppers buying the produce.
There's always some reason it's going to go up.
In California, a month of heavy rains have set farmers back weeks, if not months. And in Florida,
two or three more hours and we would have lost this crop.
Three different freezes over the past 2 weeks have disrupted citrus crops and destroyed over half the state's tomatoes.
Yeah, that's not good news. That's not good news for produce.
The executive chef at Centro in downtown Des Moines says they'll hold out as long as they can before rewriting the menu.
At some point, we will have to pass the additional cost on to the consumer, but we try to, like I said, we try to weather the storm for as long as we can. I would say probably 6 to 8 weeks.
How high will prices go, and how long will they stay up?
It's annoying because we have no control over it.
Now, the Frito Produce in Des Moines distributes produce to stores, restaurants, and schools all across the Midwest. The purchasing manager over there told me this afternoon that with several American-grown items that are hard to find right now, another option for them is looking outside the country. For instance, green beans and sweet corn are in short supply, so they can buy those vegetables from Mexican producers while they wait for the U.S. growers to recover. Stacy.
Okay, Mark Tauschek, thank you.